Hey guys, Matt Allen, Tim Little, welcome back to Tactical Bassin. Today we are headed out on the water. We've got a cold front. It's 36 degrees and raining, but we're not complaining. We know that people all over this country are struggling with the virus. Some people are even locked down, not allowed to go fishing. So today we wanted to do something different. We are literally taking you fishing, unedited, full length. Come along for a day on Clearlake.
Let's go.
All right, guys, just got to our first spot. Like Matt said in the intro, definitely changing conditions from the last few days.
Water temp looks like we are
low 50s. It's been in the high 50s, low 60s, so 7 to 8 degree
water temp, but
should be fun. We're gonna,
looks like Matt starting out with an A rig.
I'll probably start out with a jerkbait and see. You know, we had a big east wind yesterday, so it pounded this bay, so we're thinking these fish are gonna be sitting out here, but I'm gonna bring you guys along and hopefully catch some fish.
Hello. Off to a strong start.
We get that braid wet. Oh, judging by the sky, it's gonna get wet.
I don't always like fishing in the rain, but when it's 36, that's prime time.
Come on,
so what we're doing right now is just trying to draw a reaction bite. Tim's throwing the jerkbait, I'm throwing an A-rig, covering a lot of water, fishing aggressively. We know that these fish probably aren't going to want to be on a wide open feed when the water temp has dropped that far. We're up in pretty shallow water too, so it's really going to affect them. They can't get away from the cold snap. So these are baits that will draw a reaction if we go over the top of those fish. We'll do this for a little bit. We might move over, run some of these docks back here behind us, see if the fish have pulled up to the piling, and then we'll just keep moving. We will find some fish today, and hopefully we find some really big one.
Chilly.
something boiled out there behind us. I don't know if it's a bird or... I don't see a bird. Let's see if it comes up. Nothing's popped up.
We're on the board. Thanks, little dude. Just the slightest little tick on this jerkbait. Like Matt said, with this water temp dropping, these fish are probably gonna be pretty lethargic, kind of shell shocked. Probably feel just about as cold as my hands do right about now. You know it's cold when Matt's actually wearing shoes.
I thought I had that camera tipped up high enough you couldn't see that. Killing me.
But yeah. Starting to drizzle a little bit. I want to keep that lens clean off.
Got one so far. How you guys doing?
We're definitely here. We can come back later when it's warmed up to a whopping 40 and see if they're ready.
Fish.
Are you gonna slow down then?
Two docks, yeah.
As long as I'm putting it away, I can't throw it when you're going to do it.
on back.
Should we make a move?
Probably so. All right, guys, we're gonna make a move. At least Tim is on the board. He got us started. We won't make you listen to all the horrible wind noise, so we'll fire the camera back up when we get to the next stop. All right, guys, second stop of the day. Let me wipe some of this rain off the lens.
I have a towel back there for me.
Let's see if we can catch them. Did you really just boat flip that?
This guy. Nice fish, bud.
This is what you come to Clearlake for.
Watch your leg, I gotta scale out. Nice fish. Fat fish. Got her.
Got her.
Yep. She goes. Eight point four four. This guy boat flipping. I'll put her in the live well for a little bit. Nice fish, man. Nice fish.
Good work.
Maybe I'll throw a glide bait, huh?
I was wondering where you were at with the net. I'm like,
I turned around, my net wasn't where I normally have it. I'm like, what do I do?
Oh, it's in the air. That's Tim. Nice work. She was like halfway.
Yeah, that was close to the boat.
Yeah.
Well, we're 20% to 40 pounds back.
You're up. I'll take a bite, that'd be all right.
Of course, my net man duties were pretty easy too, so I can just keep doing that all day. Just stand next to the camera and watch.
Sitting at home right now, quarantined from a virus, and just watched you boat flip their PB. That was a big fish to flip. Good gracious. I'm not saying it's the biggest fish he's ever boat flipped.
It's not.
It's not. Might be the biggest one you've ever boat flipped on a light rod.
Yeah.
Throwing that, this is that Loomis 894. It's an awesome do everything rod, that four power rod. It's a 7.5 A rig, jig, Texas rig, small glide baits. Actually, this is the rod that I caught that. Oh, it's got blasted. That big one in back rack on.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
How you guys doing?
Correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, I did too.
Really? I might throw an A-rig. I think I'm about over.
They're hitting the blades.
It's interesting. Water's too murky. It's been like 4 to 6 feet of viz. Some places more than that, 10 plus foot. And now this wind blew in. We got this east wind last night. It's hammering everything. And we're like maybe a foot of visibility.
He got robbed. I thought he hit the blades. Apparently he just ate the tail.
Alright, I know when to give up. I'll throw an A-rig.
The big one choked it. Everything else has been slapping at it or eating tails.
Yeah. But also a jerkbait, glide bait, and a lipless didn't touch them while you were getting bit. That could certainly be user error.
Well, that's a given, right?
That's a given.
There might be sitting up a little deeper, maybe. With that wind?
Yeah.
Normally they sit right up here on this tule line, so that goon was more on the wall. But like Matt said, with those big waves coming in yesterday, they might have backed off. Went out to a little bit deeper water. That's good.
Hey, buddy. What'd that take? A couple of casts? He choked it too. Nice.
Another one ate it right at the boat.
cycle through it and try and get them going.
Always one or two more casts away from this one thing, but
I'm glad you're doing it. They're obviously here.
I'm having a way better day. I've had one bite, 100% hookup.
We're close. We are this close to unlocking these fish right here. They're here. Oh, we've almost got a dead battery.
We're about to switch it out.
Sorry, I'll try to make more noise next time.
Let's see.
Decisions. So, you know, we've been talking about this water clarity issue. I started out throwing a jackal re-range. This guy here. A ghost color. I'm gonna switch over to a Lucky Craft, a flash pointer, and chartreuse shad. So much bolder. I think it'll have more drawing power in this water. You know, they're gonna hear it, they're gonna come up looking for it, but they'll have a lot better time actually spotting and successfully eating the chartreuse shad. I like to throw this jerkbait in the spring on straight 12-pound fluoro. It's that X-Pride 610 medium, that jerkbait rod we love so much. They're back ordered right now. At least today they are. I don't know when they're coming back. An awesome jerkbait rod, straight fluoro. Really helps that bait just suspend and hover in the water. Hopefully it'll pay off.
Yeah.
I don't know, what are you even snagged out here?
Oh, if you're not having fun, what's the point?
Try this again. Mind if we go on around you and fish back in the back there a little bit? Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
How you guys doing today? Good. Definitely.
Yeah.
How's it going, man?
That's awesome.
What's your name?
How are you guys doing?
Real good. We got one good one right there.
Yeah, I saw you catch that one nice. Found a little group of them right there, drop shot and shaky head.
Nice.
So, hey, love all your guys' YouTube stuff.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, you guys, we got umbrella rig right here. Actually, two of them. We tied them up last night watching your videos.
Awesome.
Okay, awesome. Well, nice meeting you guys.
Nice meeting you too, Matt. Glad you're healthy and good.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. That one wasn't getting away. He had all three hooks. Nice fish. So much fun. It's interesting that they so far really committed to that rig, but hopefully we can adapt to catching some different ways. If not, we'll just keep on catching them. Love to get a good fly fish today. Would make my day.
Maybe right here.
every time we set down that A-rig.
We just shut down.
Trying to catch them with something different.
Right. Probably explain why we keep putting it down. Yeah, the A-rig, obviously it's working. We could just A-rig all day. But we've been on an A-rig bite for quite a while. So anytime you've been on a bite doing the same thing over and over, we've got these fish, they're up here pretty shallow. They're willing to eat an A-rig. And we would just love to catch them some other way. That's why we keep shifting away from it. We're like, come on, eat a lipless, eat a glide bait, eat a jerk bait. So we can just have a blast and stick them away that we haven't been catching that many fish lately. If it doesn't work, ultimately we'll go right back to the A-rig and just smash on them. But it would be fun to really catch them some different ways and trigger these fish and just keep a school going. Time will tell.
Yeah, I'm gonna switch out after this cast. Thank you.
but not that.
I know, I'm like, how many more casts is that gonna be here?
Brutal.
I don't know if you guys saw that or not, but I was hopping that LV and loaded up into a fish and it pulled away. I think I got him in the back or on the butt or something, but these fish are really lethargic. We've seen them on the graph up here, just laying in the mud, not really wanting to eat. The only thing we can, so far we can trigger them on is, well, we got one on the jerk bait and the rest on the A-rig. But we're trying. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but we got kind of a north wind starting to blow. It's always good for fishing, right?
Here we are talking like we're struggling. I've got one almost five, you've got an 8.5. When these cold snaps come in, the numbers go away. You don't catch the 20, 30, 40, 60, 100 of them. But a lot of those good ones still eat.
Yeah, we don't know if you can hear that or not. We're not running our external mic because of the rain and stuff. But what Matt was saying was when these cold fronts come in, you don't usually have the high quantity days, you know, the 20, 30, 40 fish days. But given the circumstances, one almost five, one almost 8.5 is definitely a good day. We're gonna keep chugging along and see if we can catch a few more good ones.
A 15 pounder, why not? A little crowded over here today.
Look at that. It's all good until he throws out a popper in the minnow. Might as well pack up now.
You better repeat that.
Again, the reason we're laughing, all of a sudden got a little crowded over here. And I was joking. I said, it's all good until he throws out a bobber and a live minnow. And lo and behold, that's what he did. So we'll see what happens. It'll tell us if the fish are actually here or not.
definitely there.
All right, guys, time to make another move. We'll see you in a second. All right, guys, next stop. Let's try and keep it going.
The last couple of spots that we fished have just been flats leading into spawning bays or the points going into those spawning bays. This time we're on a spot that's got a little bit of outside structure. As cold as this water is, some of these fish are bound to back out a little bit. They're not going to leave, they're not going to go backwards in the cycle, but they'll back out to the outer structure and sit on the bottom. Hopefully we can pick a couple off here, but that's at least the thinking behind this stop. Thank you.
legs in the mud. You could warm them. No input. Not even in the boat.
I don't know if you guys heard Matt. What he said was all these fish are down on the bottom. We're like 9 or 10 feet and they're all bellies in the mud. Definitely could worm them, finesse them, but we didn't bring any of that stuff.
We didn't bring any of it.
No interest in doing that, so.
We're gonna push a power fishing agenda until it continues to work. There's a lot of fish sitting on the outer side of this structure, right on the bottom. I mean, we're going over them one after another after another.
A bit?
I whacked one, no.
Oh, you hit him?
I hit him.
I They are stacked in here. Tons and tons of fish. We'll just go a few more minutes with them. If we can't convert them, we'll just keep moving. Must have had you over some of that debris.
Just got clobbered out deep. Set, pulled me into something and broke me off. Down one rig.
Brutal.
I got bit.
Yeah?
Where's the rig at?
I have a rig box in here. You might have to build one out.
I'll just put it on the shutter.
No, pull it out. Because I'm not sure. Yellow box. You proud of my organization for once? That's pretty good. Broke off. At least you got one to eat. It's crazy there's that many of them here. We couldn't convert anything. I don't know if you guys can see it, you probably can't, it's too far away, but right here at the top of the ridge is the snow line. The top part here is good, so maybe what, 600 feet above the lake, 500 feet above the lake, just turns white up there at the cloud line.
Does it normally turn white at the cloud line?
It does normally turn white at the cloud line.
with Tim.
Meteorologist over here letting you guys know that it turns white at the cloud line.
Did you say you wanted to put my A-rig back in that box? Is that what you said?
Your A-rig.
Let's make a move. No point in sitting on fish that are just totally shut down.
What was it, stop number four?
Yep. Not a lot of fish, but definitely the right.
A-rigs are great for finding fish, they're also great for finding snags. Good thing about it, if I break this one off, it's not mine. Thank you.
don't get bit in the next 10 or 15 minutes, we're going back to where we started.
Thank you.
So what we got out here is a big flat. One of the largest creeks coming into Clearlake is right here. So we got a little bit of flow with that, the storm that we just had. Water's actually warmer in the flow. There's a big flat out here and the fish will pull to that current, that warmer water, and look to feed up. So we're just kind of fishing this flat out here. If we don't get anything here in the next few minutes, we'll make another move. No rush, but when you're ready. Guys, I think we're gonna go back and I'll talk to Matt and see what we're gonna do, but I think we should go back to the first stop. We only caught that one jerkbait fish there, but there was a bunch of fish on the graph and some boils and stuff. So now that's kind of warming up, maybe we'll see if it's a timing thing and go catch some fish there. Catch you on the next stop. Got a quarter.
So we're back at our first stop. I think this is what, stop number 5 now?
Yep. Haven't been bit since stop number
3. It's warmed up a little bit. I think we're now at like, what, 40 degrees outside? But what's the water temp over here? 53.7, so it's come up a little bit. But I actually went with a square bill. There's a lot of grass out here in this flat. We're getting hung up on it with the jerkbait before, so I'm gonna try and tick the top of the grass, get that reaction bite, and Matt's gonna throw an A-rig. See if we can get some of these fish out here fired up.
Take that one, he smashed it.
Hey buddy.
Nice. We knew they were here earlier, we just couldn't get them to go, they were too cold.
That was a hook set right on cue. You got heavy. I caught a mess.
Nice.
Yeah, crappie jig. Here comes the rain again.
Barely. Nice. Look at that. Just one little skin hook. A little healthy, dude.
What jerkbait are you throwing?
Yeah.
throwing a little lucky graph pointer in that like Aurora black color.
Aurora black, yep.
Little flash. That doesn't overdo it.
I'm crimping your style again. It's following you around today.
I was just trying to catch them on something.
Oil behind it.
Besides
the A-rig,
right?
Got him.
A little deeper over there.
Thank you.
to. You know, another key this time of the year, guys, this water's warming up. You want to find that new grass, that real bright green grass. You know, this stuff that I'm catching on my LV, it's all dead grass. There's been a few patches out here that's fresh, new, and that's where those fish will sit. So pay attention to the grass you're catching on your baits. Crazy how shallow these fish will get even when it's cold out. We're fishing like 2 to 3 feet of water. Our shallow diving jerk baits are catching grass on every cast, but they're in here.
Oh, good
the outside pole.
Yeah.
Missed. Third time's a charm.
Huh?
speaking of docks, down in the comments section, let us know what kind of docks you like fishing. Right here we got an old wooden dock with wooden pilings. Right next to it we got a newer dock with metal pilings. Do you guys like fishing the metal pilings or the wood pilings? Apparently I like fishing the boat tie up.
You like fish the top of it?
Yeah, the top.
Yeah. You gotta be thorough, fish the whole dock.
I personally like fishing the older wooden pilings.
What about you? Same?
Same.
Why do you prefer that?
Just catch bigger fish off them. I think they don't heat up as quickly. I think they hold the heat better. You know, metal is a pretty good conductor of temperature, right? So it fluctuates a lot more. I think the wood is more natural. Holds bait fish and grass and underspins.
Well, should we make another move?
I don't know.
Rain's starting up.
The rain is starting.
Either way, we need to switch our camera out. We've got you guys back with a microphone, but we're gonna have to stop that as the rain's starting to come back in.
We found a couple different schools of fish, but they're just not wanting to play. It's one here, one there.
Yeah. You could jump back and forth and probably catch a lot of fish, but the schools are not close together. We got a few miles between them.
Right, yeah, in between our stops, you're looking at probably 3 to 5 miles. I'm not even sure how long this video is, but hopefully you guys are enjoying it. It's nice just being out here. A little cold, but any day of fishing is a good day, right?
That's right.
Come on.
All right, let's make a move.
All right, guys, we're gonna make a move. We're switch out batteries. Catch you at the next stop.
All right, guys, we got back here to the 8-pounder spot. We're gonna fish a little bit deeper. As we were leaving this spot to go to our 4th spot, we noticed a bunch of fish on the side imaging out on the flat. We're gonna fish out here, see if we can trigger some of those fish that are laying on the bottom with their bellies in the mud to eat something.
As an added bonus, it's about 40 degrees, but now it's blowing. And my hat flew off on the way here. And it's freezing. We had to stop because I had a brain freeze. It was so bad. Just adding to the fun of the day. Giant would definitely warm me right up. I feel it in my bones now. It's cold. Thank you.
just didn't happen on a perfect cast.
Show that to the camera.
Got him. I got him in the mouth too. He clamped on that hook. Look at that. It's in there. He clamped down on it. Great big freshwater clam. And he clamped shut on my Miss Swim Bait. That's pretty funny. Never know what you're gonna get.
I think it slid out deeper. It's just mud bottom.
That's right.
I banged into something. My bait's done for. It's not warm.
Jeez.
unwillingness to slow down with finesse is starting to push towards stubborn. But darn it, they're gonna do it our way.
What we're doing right now is just fan casting out on this mud. It's literally bare mud. Clearlake is a natural lake. It's got a little dam on it that raises it a few extra feet, but it's a natural lake. And as a result, you end up with a lot of these big mud flats or big open water bare areas, just like you would have on a little tiny natural lake, like a pond or something. Just big, slow sloping areas, wide open bays and spawning flats. So these fish will sometimes be out on seemingly nothing. I mean, truly nothing. Bare mud, 500 yards from anywhere, but they follow the most subtle little contours, you know, around the outside edges of these flats or out off the ends of the main lake points. They can be out there a quarter mile and they'll be on just the slightest little change that you can hardly even see, but they'll follow that up into the shallows to spawn. They stay on those little minor things. So when it's a day like this and the fish really aren't cooperating, although it's hard to say that when you caught a giant, but we're not getting a lot of bites, it's hard to just keep fan casting out there in that bare open water, but it works. You've got to do it.
Right out from under your foot.
Man, it's cold.
And rainy.
Thinking if we go a few more minutes and don't get one, let's not kill ourselves. Let's run back like towards the boat ramp, get a spot or two, and we'll call it a day.
It was getting rain on the.
Yep. If we were catching them good, we'd sit out here. But if it's gonna keep slowing down, slowing down, slowing down, we don't need to freeze to death. One more cast.
I think these fish have accepted that it's a cold, nasty day. They are done. All right, let's head back over by the ramp. We'll run all the way across the lake, guys. We'll hit another spot or two closer to home. If we don't get into them, we're gonna wrap it up. We thought we'd fish a full day. It might be a half day. All right, guys, last stop. Hopefully we can end this on a high note, catch some more fish, maybe get another big one. Let's find out. Thank you. There's a lot of fish out here right now. Hopefully they convert, but there's a ton of them out here on this flat.
Bass. Right. It's in strong.
This is all just a perfect 10-foot mud flat. Totally flat. There's a creek over here and it'll come up going into that creek, but all this out here is just the same. It's raining.
see it? It's like, there's like 10 people on it.
High note, low note. I think I'm about 10 minutes from done. Jeez. We'll finish this out.
Thank you.
seems like these fish have totally shut down.
Completely. Why don't you keep fishing? And I'll kind of explain. I'll go through the baits that we chose today. And kind of why. And then, guys, I think we'll wrap it up. Because I'm cold. He's tougher than me, but he's cold too. He just won't say it. It's freaking freezing out here. Let me grab my rods and I'll explain it. Alright, springtime bass fishing. We've done a ton of videos about it. We've talked about every different style and way to catch these fish. But I think it's very telling when you get to look at what we actually tied on when we knew we were going to come out here with you guys all day and just throw these baits. There are some things that aren't tied on. There are some things that are tied on that I think are telling. So I brought 6 rods total. Did you bring the same? You brought the same. We showed up with literally the same stuff tied on. Not the same models, but baits from the same genres, same categories. And that's for very specific reasons. So running through them, first one is a Kitec on a flashy swimmer. I brought a 4.8. I think Tim brought a 4.3. Just a little smaller. This is the only bait...
I'm looking to make sure. Yeah.
This is the only bait in the entire lineup that doesn't fit that true reaction category. And speaking for myself, and I assume Tim is the same, the reason why I had this tied on is in case we really got into a mob of them. You know, what we were hoping to do today was catch some nice fish, which we did. We accomplished that. He got a giant. We had some other really, really nice fish, but we were hoping the numbers of fish would be higher and more consistent, more spread out. That didn't happen because of our conditions, but the goal was to get on a mob of them and just catch a bunch of fish. And the Kitec, particularly with that blade under it, that flashy swimmer, is a bait that we could throw over and over through those fish because it's weedless. We're not going to get snagged if they're up in the junk. With that extra flash, the whole goal is to keep fish fired up. So if we were catching them on an A-rig or a glide bait or a square bill or a lipless and they shut down, it's a different offering that we can put right back in there. No concern about getting snagged up, just a different look, a different profile, and hopefully keep those fish aggressive, keep them biting. So that's why that was on the boat. Next up, all the rest of these baits We tied on specifically because we were trying to trigger a reaction. You're trying to get these fish to aggressively feed whether or not they want to. Bass have this core response where if there's an injured bait fish nearby and it moves ever so slightly and sends out that signal that says, I'm not doing well, they just have this core reaction to eat it. So the A-rig is a prime example. This is that Hog Farmer Flex rig. The A-rig is a prime example of a bait that when you twitch it and work it, you know, it's swimming through the water. All 5 baits are swimming parallel. They're all swimming together. But you watch and you see how aggressively we pump the rod or pump that reel handle, and that whole rig spreads out and comes back together. It's got all this movement. It perfectly mimics if a bass ran up on a bunch of real bait fish, a little school of bait swimming along the shore, they freak out, they spread out. But as soon as they do that, strength is in numbers, so they come right back together. And it mirrors that, and those bass just lash out. And today they did. That's what Tim got the big one on. Really, it's what we got all the best fish on. It's amazing how well that works. Next up is the lipless. Specifically, we were throwing the LV500. I went with a phantom ghost color, and we'll link you all the gear down in the video description, every bit of it, so you know exactly what we were throwing. Tim went with Aurora Black, which is a flashier, brighter color. I actually think when we actually got out,
you bit?
Yeah.
when we actually got out here and saw how much the wind had churned up the lake yesterday and really muddied up the water in a lot of our spots, he was better with that Aurora than I was with a Ghost, but just left it tied on, kept trying to get bit on that. But fishing that LV, you're hopping bottom. It's that same thing. If the fish are lethargic, sitting in the mud, and that thing comes and flutters and vibrates and has all that racket and sound right past their face, they just vacuum that thing up. Three more. The square bill. I went with a Little John. Tim went with a Biggie, both in red, which I think is also very telling. Different baits, same theory. These fish get so aggressive on that shallow running red crankbait in the spring, and you want to be aggressive with it. Burn, 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 pause. Burn, pause, burn, 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 pause. And those fish, when that thing stops, they see it fly by, and they have this reaction to chase. It's just built into them. But then when it stops, and they're already chasing, they just open up and eat that thing. So that was the theory there. The glide. Put a little bit of time into the glide today, but not a lot. We've been catching some nice glide fish lately, but this cool down is just not prime time for it. Still worth a try, but the same deal with the glide. You get this slow, methodical action, but then when you twitch that rod, that bait will cut and dart. It's literally the exact same thing, playing out with all these different baits. That thing will kick and those fish just react and eat it. This particular glide is a sneaky Pete. This is one of the baits that we would consider a cover glide. It's designed to be fished up in shallow water, around cover, around structure, where you know those fish are there, you know the bait is near them, it's not way up over them. You're in the same water column as them, 3, 5, 6, 8 feet of water. And when you twitch it, it's already right there and they just lash out. And then last but not least, the jerkbait. I never got a jerkbait bite today. Tim caught two nice fish on it. I was throwing a flash pointer. He was throwing the standard pointer, the pointer 100. I started out with a Ghost color, went to a chartreuse shad. He was throwing Aurora Black, which again is a chrome color with some flash to it. But the whole theory with the jerkbait, same exact thing, aggressive movement followed by dead still. These jerkbaits, you don't realize how loud they are underwater. Unless you've seen some of our underwater footage where the fish just come out and eat them, you can hear just how much racket they make. So they make a ton of racket, sharp, aggressive movements, and then they just hover. And those fish, if you let that bait sit, will just come up to it. They start to eyeball it. And then when it takes off again, same thing. Core reaction, they lash out. It's really important with the jerkbait that you throw it on a proper rod because you don't want the bait to swim. It needs to be hard, sharp movements to dead stop. Move, stop. You don't want it to start to kick and then take off. Start to kick, take off. Doesn't work anywhere near as well as those sharp, aggressive movements. So again, we'll link all the gear down in the video description for you. Today was a completely different format than we have ever done. I enjoyed it. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. I mean, given the circumstances.
Yeah, the weather was a little brutal, but doing it this way was really fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, let us know down in the comments, because obviously this style of video is new to us. If you want to see this continue, you want to come out and do full days of fishing with us, just let us know. We're open to your suggestions. It was a lot of fun. It was awesome to watch Tim catch that great big one. Guys, we appreciate you. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications so you know when new videos are coming. And we'll talk to you soon.